Ugh, spaceports all smell the same. Engine exhaust, coolant fluid, and spacers who haven't bathed in a week. Let's get out of this stink. Whatever the rest of Drummond Cost is like, the air has gotta be fresher than in here.
I would've figured you'd been to Drummond Cost before.
Brayden and I moved around a lot when we first got together, but we never made it here. Keep in mind, Imperials aren't fond of aliens. Step out of line, and they'll notice. If we tweak the local authorities, they can make life really hard.
My goal is to join the Great Hunt. That's it.
Still, let's try to keep a low profile. Come on, the Mandalorian Enclave is in the Citadel. Our contact is someone named Chris DeMarcon.
And then I told him, "You think that's cold? You should see what I did to the Gamorrean. I never saw a Rodian run so fast in my... Oh, sorry, sweetie, didn't see you there. What can I do for you?"
We are here for the Great Hunt. We've been sponsored by Nemro the Hutt.
An all-girls hunted team. Good for you. How long you two been partners?
Feels like Mako's always been there to back me up.
Fantastic. It's rare to see that kind of solidarity in our business, you know? You probably ain't gonna like what I'm about to tell you. But there's nothing I can do about it, understand? There's one spot left open in the Great Hunt, and over 36 hunters who got sponsorships.
Those other hunters can go home. That spot is mine.
It's yours if you can get it. Lots of folks will be thinking the same thing, though. The Huntmaster himself will explain how we're gonna sort things out. Head into the main room, and show some respect. When the Huntmaster's done talking, come on back in here. I'll be handling you from here on out.
Quiet! Quiet, you dogs! The Huntmaster is about to speak. Pay attention and show some respect for once in your lives. You heard the Huntmaster. You're competing for the last spot in the Great Hunt by taking down 3 bounties on Drummond Cost.
You expect us to hunt here with Imperials crawling all over us and Sith?
Let the man talk. I want to hear this.
For all you overblown, useless, no-talent cowards, we installed a handy exit door. Use it now! The rest of you, the real hunters, go see your handlers. They'll get you oriented to the planet and assign you 3 unique bounties. Everyone who takes down all 3 of their bounties wins a spot in the final melee. Anyone who doesn't get all 3 is out.
Hunting on Drummond Cost? That's suicide. I'm grabbing the first shuttle out of here. I suggest you do the same, friend.
I want into the Great Hunt, and this is the only way.
Then watch your back. It's not the jungles that are dangerous on Drummond Cost. It's the people. I'm done here. May your quarry fall before you, Hunter.
Well, what are you standing around for? Act your handler. That's Krista for you, new blood.
A dozen cowards just scurried out of here. Probably won't stop till Drummond Cost is light years behind him. You understand the basics, right? 3 bounties, hardest targets on Drummond Cost. Gotta get all 3 to qualify for the final melee.
What exactly is this melee I keep hearing about?
Ooh, it's a big old scrap. Everybody who gets all 3 of their bounties goes into the rage pit. One comes out. Now let's see who your first target is. Whoa, this can't be right. You got enemies among the Mandalorians or something?
Just Taro Blood, the Mandalorian who killed Brayden. What'd he do?
It'll be fine. What are we dealing with here?
I wouldn't wish this bounty on anybody. Gotta play the hand you're dealt, though. The target's a Republic noble named Valtaka. He got captured during an Imperial raid, brought back here, and sold into slavery by mistake.
Why was selling him into slavery a mistake?
He should have been ransomed, but Valtaka wasn't properly identified when he got captured. Valtaka's slave group was building a big old statue in the jungle. The slaves rebelled and took over the site. Nobody can get in there. We don't even know if he's still alive. If he is, the family will pay big.
Will the family pay big for a corpse?
They'll pay for the body, but not as much as alive. Details are on the hire slip. The slaves got themselves a tent camp near that statue they never finished. If Altaka's still kicking, he's probably somewhere in there. Before you go, meet your new best friend. the S-86K full-gauge carbonite armor upgrade. You can't shoot a fella with this while he's springing around. It's too slow to charge up. But once that fella ain't resisting, say, after a good long beating, the S-86K will freeze him for transport.
Didn't know they made devices to freeze people.
Carbonite ain't so much freezing as it is... Well, I ain't got a clue, really. Just have fun.
You find that Republic Noble fella and claim that first bounty, then hurry it on back here as fast as you can.
Dear Altaka, when I got your message, I could scarcely believe it. We have found each other after all these years.
Oh, looks like a love letter. From an Imperial Noble, no less. Juicy.
Why would a noble be writing love letters to a slave?
That's what I want to know.
It must have been the Force that brought you here to Drummond Cass, dear Altaka. As for your predicament, fear not. I have friends in high places, and for the right price, they have agreed to help me. When the slaves attempt their pitiful revolution, a man will come to you dressed in rags. He will bring you to me. I shall say you are my missing brother. We will be Lord and Lady Dekar. I'm afraid I cannot get you off-world and back to your beloved family, but I promise to make your every moment here a joy. Our lifestyle will be the envy of all, and we'll attend parties at the Nexus Room every night. Be ready to join me, my love.
Wait, so the lady is his lover, but now he's posing as her brother? That's disgusting. Sounds like the Nexus Room is where we'll find these weirdos.
This whole planet is weird.
I am with you there. Let's go meet this Lord and Lady Dekar. Lead on, boss.
There, sir. Just as I said.
That looks like her, all right.
Bounty Hunter, I am Sergeant Warlax of the Imperial Navy. You are commanded to hand over all your weapons and gear immediately.
How about I just hand over the ammo instead?
Don't get cute, off-world scum. You're lucky to be breathing the same air as me, alien. Don't push your luck.
Sergeant, Taro Blood here. Have you completed my little errand yet?
Blood, you steaming pile of filth!
Blast it! I told you not to call on this channel!
Getting others to do your dirty work? That's just low.
Oh, this is ridiculously tiresome. She's still alive? What is wrong with you, Sergeant?
Sir? Who's that guy?
Blood, I'll talk to you later. Ignore the chatter, men. Let's take this hunter in.
I don't know what's going on here, Sarge, but I know it stinks.
Yeah. Either you cut us in on this deal, or we walk.
You can't spend credits if you're all dead.
That makes a whole lot of sense. Let's get out of here.
I'm with you.
Cowards! The rest of you, attack!
Yes, may I help you with something?
Darling, please don't speak to that... thing.
It's clearly not supposed to be here, and we shouldn't let ourselves look like we approve. Come, let us get a drink.
Not much of a family resemblance between you and your, brother.
We had different mothers. Yes, that's right. We're only half-siblings. Unless I'm misremembering.
Stow it, darling. Just feel the smug knowledge radiate from her. We knew this might happen eventually.
Yeah, only so long you can keep dating your brother before something goes wrong.
So you know our little secret. What does an insignificant creature like you want? What would make you dare threaten a noble?
The, Lord here is wanted back at home.
At home? But that means... You told me I was trapped here. That I would have to forget my family. That this charade was the only way.
Inside voice, darling. I may have exaggerated a bit, but hasn't it been nice here? The parties, the late nights, the intrigues and such?
You witch! Keeping me here as your plaything when I could have been home with my sisters and dear mother.
Ugh, you could be such a whiny pain. It's a wonder your nobility. Let us make a new deal, Bounty Hunter.
Make this fast, lady. I've got other things to do.
My darling, my lovely Altaka. Wouldn't you rather stay here with me than run home to your pathetic Republic family?
What? Of course not. You treat me like a pet and this planet is disgusting. In fact, I'd rather...
Yes, you've made your tiresome viewpoint clear. Then here is what I propose. I assume Altaka's family will pay less for just his body. Kill him, show me the slip, and I'll compensate you the difference.
What? You wanted to kill me?
I don't kill people, unless I have to.
You've made a very big mistake here today. Now take this thing and leave. Your kind does not belong here.
Aw, I thought we were bonding.
Just leave.
Hey there, Hunter. Competition out there is something crazy. A couple of hunters died in the jungles. Big Trandoshan got arrested by the Imperials. And you found yourself an unfindable Republic noble. His family was plenty generous with their live bounty.
Nobody should have to go through what that man suffered.
Nobody understands why women do themselves so well in the hunts. It's the empathy. Your second bounty's a bit of a mystery. Apparently, whoever's stacking the deck against you is gonna keep right on stacking.
Hardly surprising.
What I got here is a classified red flag request from Imperial Command. No details, just flashy warnings and a contact. Admiral Frabal, Imperial Navy.
I don't see what the big deal is.
Imperials think aliens are disposable. Alien bounty hunters rank somewhere below droids. Here's the slip. Frabal's in the city, not all that far a stroll. Go get him.
This is the office of Admiral Frabal of the Imperial Navy. Do you have business here?
Can I just be here to talk to you?
Yes, well, are you? Just here to talk to me, I mean? Oh, I see, you're making fun of me.
I can't imagine why he'd think you were making fun of him and his big important desk.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm very busy.
Let me in there, now.
I really couldn't care less what you...
What's all that racket out there, soldier?
There's a quarrelsome alien here, Admiral. It refuses to leave.
Quarrelsome? You're as weak as you are, stupid. I requested a mercenary from the Mandalorians. Send that person in immediately.
Yes, sir. You may go in now.
I'll bet you get a demerit for that, Lieutenant.
You're terrible.
The Admiral is waiting.
Come in, mercenary. I apologize if my secretary caused you grief. He is of low birth and his intelligence reflects it. I'm afraid many of our Imperial soldiers are hopeless with delicate tasks. This is, of course, why I asked for a professional.
Bad soldiers are a result of bad leadership.
Often true, unfortunately. I haven't the luxury of training my assistants personally. I must take what Central Command sends me. That, of course, is neither here nor there. You've come to perform a service. My daughter has become something of a liability to me. I want you to kill her.
That's something you don't hear every day.
Then I'll assume you're newly arrived to Dromund Kaas. Things work a bit differently here. My daughter was born force-sensitive and trained to be Sith. A great honor for our family. Unfortunately, my daughter's master is one Lord Grathan, a madman who is now disgraced in the eyes of the Dark Council.
Why not just get her a new master?
It's outside of my control. The Sith manage their own affairs, the rest of us merely suffer the consequences. If Lord Grathan's compound is raided and my daughter captured or killed, every member of her family will suffer. This is Sith politics. In the best-case scenario, I lose my rank and position. In the worst...
You get squashed like a bug?
An inelegant way to phrase it, but yes. Lord Grathan is a paranoid madman. His compound is built to withstand a siege. But a lone infiltrator will take them by surprise. My daughter is somewhere inside Lord Grathan's compound. Her name is Veretta. You will know her as she resembles me closely.
I'll handle this. Quiet and quick.
Hang on, I've been running some data. Turns out renegade Sith Lord followers rack up death marks like crazy. Lord Grathan's top people all have prices on their heads.
It'd be a shame to let those bounties go to waste.
And we might need those extra credits to gear you up for the big melee.
Remember, discretion is essential. Do not let yourself be captured. Good luck.
Oh, what have we here? You're not even a Mandalorian, are you? When Lord Grathan's spy said my father contacted the Mandalorian Enclave, I expected they'd at least send me a real live Mandalorian. I'm afraid I'm a tad disappointed.
What does it matter who kills you?
A woman has to have standards. Wait, you don't seriously think you can kill me? I mean, I'm a Sith, and you're just... whatever you are.
Oh, we've got a true believer.
Then again, it makes sense. Why would you come here if you thought you'd die? Apparently, my father isn't the only one living in a dream world. You can't kill a Sith, you silly.
You believe you're invincible, little girl?
No, of course not. A more powerful Sith could kill me. Or a really lucky Jedi, I suppose. Perhaps a bomb, but not some random bounty hunter. You must be so crushed. Live and learn, I guess. Except, not in your case. Sorry.
What? I lost? I can't lose. I'm Sith.
You were Sith. Now you're just done.
Can't die like this, falling to some common bounty hunter. Everything Lord Grothan told me was a lie. I've been living in a dream world. It can't end like this. It can't.
It's time you and your father had a chat.
No, that's worse.
Reports of the raid on Lord Grathan's estate are pouring in. I trust you were successful in your endeavor. My daughter, Veretta, is...
I made her into a fancy paperweight.
You froze her? Why? I was so specific in my directions. Why in the galaxy would you do this? Why would you refuse a specific order and not eliminate the target?
I figured it was a family affair.
You're incredibly insightful for a bounty hunter. As soon as you left the premises, I realized my mistake. A mistake that would haunt me the rest of my days.
We weren't about to let that happen, sir.
You've done me a great service, Hunter. She's all I have of her mother.
You're not gonna kill her?
No, of course not. Contain her, maybe, until she can be made to see reason. Here is your writ and your fee. Now, please. I need some time with my daughter.
Second bounty is done. Just one more, and I'm in the melee.
Right you are. And competition is heating up.
That little green girl, Iopian Rattle, finished all her bounties. Heard she poisoned an Imperial moth.
Lucky we didn't get that one. Not sure how we'd work it out.
Now, I ain't allowed details on whatever you were scrapping for Admiral Fabal. But I got a clearance note says it was duly scrapped. Nice payday, too.
There was a squabble between the Admiral and his Sith daughter. Complicated.
Sounds right tricky. But less I know, the better. Here we go. Bounty 3. I call it, someone's got a serious hate for my hunter. Top secret, crazy, red flag covered. This one's for a Captain Metal in Imperial Intelligence. No other information.
Looks like I'm working for spies this time.
Better not want us to poison someone.
Stay careful. Get this one done, and don't get yourself dead in the process.
What the...
Oh, right. The bounty hunter. Glad you could make it. Feeling nervous, alien? Standing in the middle of Imperial Intelligence?
I can say one word, or touch one button, and you'd disappear forever.
Poof. Gone. Just like that. No one would even dare to ask what happened to you.
Are you threatening me, Captain?
What?
No. Just showing you what I deal with all day. I never signed up for this cloak and dagger stuff. I was a regular soldier. Then one day, I put together a covert op raid that goes a little too well. And bam, I'm in Imperial Intelligence. Look, what I'm saying is the stuff that goes on in these halls is insane. And all of it is crazy hush-hush. So what I'm going to tell you has to stay just between you and me. Got it?
My price tag always includes the cost of discretion.
Here's the deal. There's a huge ancient Sith temple on Drummond Cass. Used to just sit there being scary. Now the place is crawling with Sith sorcery, and it's been ordered a no-go zone for everyone. Naturally, we sent a team in. My commander led that team. Nobody came back. We can't report any of them dead without reporting the mission, which puts me in a bind.
I still don't see what you need me for.
If I can't prove my commander's dead, I can't take over his spot, which means an ugly power vacuum. I'm hiring you to enter that temple and find the team's ID cards, especially my commander's. I need those IDs to create more acceptable deaths for them.
What if this commander and his team are still alive?
They're not. And even if they are, they're not. Understood. Make sure you find an Imperial commander named Gargan. Can't imagine there'll be more than one corpse in a temple wearing commander stripes. Grab all the team's ID cards and double-time it back here, quietly.
What is this in front of me? Another worshipper?
Who braves the flames of the Altar of Horror to stand in front of Lord Baral Slathborn, Lord of the Sith?
This tomb has driven you insane, Lord.
Insane? No. Do not seek madness, but fear and hatred, the tools of the Sith!
Where's your lightsaber, my lord? Don't you feel naked without it?
Insolence! You will perish in flames! To me, my disciples!
You got DIDs? Fantastic. Let me see. That's Commander Gargan's, all right. What was it like in the Dark Temple? I've yet to hear anything that didn't sound like pure raving.
Just some weird lights. No big deal.
Huh. Still wish I could have got in myself. Would have saved me some unpleasantness. Listen to me. Unpleasantness. I'm even starting to talk like a spy. Friend, remember when I said Sith didn't want anyone in the Dark Temple?
That ain't sounding too good.
I wish there was another way to handle this, I really do. I can't risk the Sith ever finding out you went into their precious Dark Temple, which means you're now a liability. I apologize. This isn't the way a fighting woman should die.
Guards!
That went wrong, didn't it? Got a hole in my gut. I'm not going to beg. Turning on someone who did their job is wrong. We both know it. Here's your writ. It tells the Mandalorians you did your job. And here's your pay. The rest is up to you.
Bribe me, Captain, and do it well.
That I can do. I've got all sorts of resources at my disposal. I'll send you some top-of-the-line weaponry as soon as you're out of here. That work for you?
I'm glad this didn't have to get personal.
It never was. Believe me, you're everything a woman should be. Wish I'd met you when I was still a man. What's done is done. Good hunting to you.
You're alive! Some Mandalorian big shot named Taro Blood said you were dead. They're about to start the melee without you.
Do I look dead to you?
Not hardly. In fact, you look like a woman who's been kicking around some sad men.
All the other hunters who survived are already inside. Get in there!
If I die, bury my credits with me.
No inheritance, huh? Thanks a lot.
Don't get cute. Move!
And the last hunter left standing joins the great hunt. Simple as that. All weapons are allowed, but you fight alone. No assistance! And it looks like we have a latecomer.
Somebody made up a story I was dead.
Your competitors were relieved to hear it. Too bad for them, huh? Huntmaster, will you do us the honor?
We all heard tales of your exploits, Hunter. Perhaps I'll turn them into a song to commemorate your death.
Make sure it's something you can dance to.
Consider it done. I'd wish you luck, but it wouldn't help, so I'll just say goodbye.
Enough! You hunters are the best that the galaxy's goons and thug lords could send us. Now show us which one of you will join the great hunt. Fight! The melee is over! One hunter remains! Quite a show you put on. Blasted fun to watch. How do you feel, Hunter?
I just stomped my competition into the dirt. I feel great.
Enjoy it. Things only get harder from here. This is simply ridiculous. I mean, really. This needs to stop right now.
Blood, come here and face me.
No! No! No unsanctioned kills in the Great Hunt!
You see? That's a perfect example. I must object to this farce. That thing does not deserve to enter the Great Hunt. Her credentials are a lie, fabricated by her little gutter rat of a sidekick. She deserves no honors.
You lying, cheating, murdering scum!
We know this hunter's history, Blood. The Huntmaster has ruled. You fools! This is a place of honor, a competition of elites. Mandalore will hear of this.
I'm ready to settle this right now. How about you?
Enough! Before this great hunt is over, I will have your skull in my hands.
Well, the great hunt just got way more interesting. Sorry to interrupt, Huntmaster. Please continue. You get all that, Hunter?
What happens when I win this contest?
Fame, glory, wealth, and a chance to work with Mandalore, the greatest leader in the galaxy. You'll be hunting targets spread across the galaxy. There'll be at least one other hunter going for them, too. You not only have to take down your target, you have to eliminate the other hunters.
What if I don't get to my targets first?
Then you'll have hunters gunning for you instead of the other way around. Your handler, Krista, will fill you in on the rest of the details. She's waiting for you.
Ooh, what a thrashing! The other handlers are all bug-eyed jealous you won. Now, on to the great hunt. I expect you want to hear about your targets.
I wiped the floor with my competition back there.
I know. Snuck me a peek while it was happening. Good fun. Here's how it's gonna work. First, you're getting a starship.
How's that going to happen?
Well, let's just say you're not quite done here on Dromund Kaas.
On your ship's computer, you'll access two holorecordings, both with specific details on who and where you hunt.
What's Taro Blood going to be doing?
The same thing. That's how the Great Hunt works. Each target will have another hunter assigned to it. You have to locate that rival and take him out, too.
Maybe we'll get lucky and Taro Blood will be on their first target.
Now, about your ship, there's a tradition for new hunters. You gotta steal one for yourself.
Guess I'll be heading to the spaceport.
Not quite yet. Gotta find you the right ship first.
Gotcha. I know one that belongs to one of them so-called importer types. Fast, smooth, and roomy.
I'll pull together your holorecordings for the great hunt targets and transmit them when you hit space. Meantime, head to the spaceport. Get past whatever guards are around, steal your ship, and hit the hyperlanes.
I'm off on the great hunt.
Your first round of targets are on Balmora and Nar Shaddaa. Good luck to you, Hunter.
All right, you disgusting pile of puke! Drop your weapon and kiss the floor! This is one starship that's not getting stolen on my watch. You hear me, scum?
What are you people doing in my hangar?
Your hangar? That's rich. You think you can steal the hangar as well, you verminous lout? I've had three ships stolen this year by the Mandalorians and their unwashed cohorts. Of course, not all Mandalorians are bad. Taro Blood was nice enough to tell me about this little tradition of yours.
If you want to die, I'm not arguing.
Karagimi, a nikag nikag, kanyak gak akigwamjam.
You heard the man? Get her!
Rules or no rules, Taro Blood dies the next time we see him. Right?
That scum is living on borrowed time.
Oh, I hate this. I don't want to feel this way about anyone, but I want to make him pay.
Don't worry, Mako. It's gonna be all right.
Don't get all mushy on me. I was just saying is all. We better get moving. We've got a great hunt to win, right?
I am 2VR8, that totem droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
Your last master isn't coming back. Got a problem with that?
Absolutely not. He called me unpleasant names and never bathed. Not that there is anything wrong with that, master. I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard this Kuat Drive Yard's D5 Mantis patrol craft. Its speed and firepower are unmatched by other vessels of its class. You'll find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoterminal. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions, Master?
Are you at least capable of providing security while I'm not aboard?
I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand the stress. However, should any errands arise that are beneath your superior status, please do not hesitate to call upon me. I function to serve you. Whenever you are ready to depart, consult the galaxy map on your bridge. It will program the proper astrogation coordinates and activate the engines.
Hunter, good. We need every ship we can get. The Republic grows bolder. Their attack squadrons ambush Imperial targets and disappear into open space. We're struggling to compete.
Sounds like the Empire needs my help. Again.
Correct. We're placing an open bounty on this Republic scum. I've scrambled the Cast 23rd and Dreadwing, but it's not enough. We're forming an exclusive response squadron, the Empire's Fury. According to your skill set, I'm nominating you for squadron leader. Care to help our fleet rout the Republic?
I'm representing the Imperial fleet. I think I deserve something extra.
I'm authorized to dispense a generous signing bonus. Your call sign will be Scree. Uploading mission data to your ship now. You'll work alone, while the rest of the squadron assists throughout the galaxy. Strike with fury. Strike for the Empire.